never stop fighting. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, honorable judges, fellow opponents, and guests. You feel the rush of glare in your face. You feel the adrenaline surging inside of you. You feel free. Figure skating is a very graceful and elegant sport. Professional skaters spend hundreds of dollars to get the perfect set of equipment to suit their needs. The moves they do require effort and precision. They can put under so much pressure, they worry about forgetting a move, messing up, or worst of all, not forming the program. To some skaters, skating is just a sport. To others, it's life. If you want to be a professional skater, whether you're a figure skater, a hockey player, or a speed skater, you have to have good quality equipment. Basically, everything you need as a skater should be good quality. Whether you're a boy or a girl, the outfit is a big part of your performance. The judges count points for the outfit. If you're wondering what the heel and the boot is for, you'll probably want to hear this. The heel is to help us skaters stay on the ball of our feet easier. Some skaters prefer to have higher heels, like dancers for instance. They need to have deeper edges for the type of skating they do. The pick on the toe of the boot is the part that allows us to do the jumps and spins. The pick is the pivot point of the spins. Did you know that the first pair of ice skates was just a sandal with a piece of shaped and carved bone strapped underneath? If you don't have good quality equipment, then you might not be able to do some of the moves you need to do as a figure skater, some of which I'll be sharing with you shortly. The tricks we do sometimes look easy, but the thing is, they're really not. There are tons of different moves. Take a spiral, for example. In a spiral, you need quite a bit of balance. What you do is you lift up your leg behind you into an L shape or higher. Some skaters can actually get their legs to be perfectly straight behind them. You can also do this move in a spin. It's called a counter spin. Did you know that the first person ever to complete a quadruple jump in competition was Canadian curve running? One of the many jumps is the flip. The flip is a jump. Reach behind you with your right foot wearing a left foot inside edge. Then you kick into the ice and spin in the air for at least 1.5 rotations. There are also lots of other moves, such as the loop, shoot the duck, sit spin, and axe. Now do you understand why I said that the tricks we do aren't easy? And with a tough critique, we don't have much room for mistakes. Some movements, accessories, and props are not permitted in competition. If you're late getting on the ice, then you get deducted points. Competition is hard. If you're late by 6 to 15 seconds, you get 0.4 to 1.2. If you're late by 15 seconds or more, then you get 1.1 to 1.5 points taken. You can get pretty harsh. If you fall or cause a brief interruption, then you get 0.1 points taken. In every competition, your score starts at 15. The judges count points for 5 different elements: skating skills, transition, linking footwork and movement, performance, choreography, and interpretation. There are also things you can't do in competition, like rolling on the ice, cartwheels, lying or kneeling, and backflips. Believe it or not, there are a lot of things you can't do on the ice. Figure skating is a very graceful and elegant sport. The right equipment means a lot when it comes to competition. The moves we do are sometimes very hard to learn. Deductions are quick delays. Skaters are under a lot of pressure, but in the end,